This video is part 2 of my chemistry series. So in part 1, I already showed you step by step how you should prepare for your chemistry by using my powerful method. And I took carbon compound this chapter as the example to show you in part 1. So a lot of students, they found that my method is so useful until the point where they still remember the details of carbon compound even when their SPM exam is already over. So from there, we can see how effective my method is. Hence, I want you to enhance your understanding of my method so that you can know how to play around with my method to master the other topic as well. So make sure you watch this part 1 first, the video link is here. So in this video, I will show you another example, which is your voltage and electrolytic cell from your form 5 chapter 1 redox to see how my method works well in the other topic as well, so that you will know how to play around with the other topic after you leave this video later. Alright, so let's check it out. Alright, so let's look at voltage cell and electrolytic cell. So this part is in your textbook page 27 to 43. So voltage cell, we also call it as chemical cell. For electrolytic cell, we have battery. But for chemical cell, we don't have battery. These are the basic things that you have to master under these two subtopics. So in this video, we will cover the first 3 points. So this is the conclusion that I made using my method. That means during exam, by looking at the question, I just have to apply these 2 steps, then I can solve the question already. So this conclusion helped me to simplify everything. So during exam, when you look at a question, the first step that you have to do is to refer to either enoch value or battery's terminal. If it is an electrolytic cell, then we have battery, then we can look at the battery terminal. If you cannot find battery, that means it is chemical cell, then only we have to look at the enoch value. That means if we have battery, then we look at battery. If we don't have battery, then only we look at enoch value. So this is the first step. The second step is to refer to this acronym. So Catherine read books, so she become more positive because she read book, so she become more positive, and also she gain examples from this book. So it's very logical. Read books, become more positive, and then you gain examples. So what does it mean? So Catherine stands for cathode. Read stands for reduction. More positive stands for enoch value, more positive. Gain example stands for gain electrons. So this line will be the part that we have to refer during our exam. So listen, at cathode, reduction occur. So the species that has the enoch value that is more positive will undergo reduction, and this species will gain electron. So if you ask, what about oxidation? Oxidation is just the opposite of this. We just have to turbulate everything. Reduction become oxidation, cathode become anode, enoch value become more positive, we change to enoch value become more negative, gain electron, we change to lose electron. We just have to turbulate everything for oxidation. So for now, you just have to remember this line for reduction, this acronym. So these are the 2 steps when we want to solve a question. So let's try. For chemical cell, that means we don't have batteries. So we cannot refer to the battery's terminal. So instead, we have to refer to the enoch value. So how to determine which species undergo reduction or oxidation? So the first step, we refer to the enoch value. And the second step, we have to refer to this acronym. Since we refer to enoch value, so we see this part. The species that has the enoch value that is more positive will undergo reduction at cathode. So we compare these 2 enoch value. Which one more positive? This one, right? So this species will undergo reduction. So let's try the next question. For electrolytic cell, So now we got what? We got battery. So we have to refer to the battery's terminal. How to determine which species undergo reduction or oxidation? So the first step, refer to the battery's terminal. The longer side will be positive, the shorter side will be negative. The second step, refer to this acronym. So now for electrolytic cell, we refer to the battery's terminal. That means we won't focus on the enoch value, right? So we don't look at this part. Instead, we look at this part, gain electron. To know which electrode gain electron, we have to know the direction of electron flow. So to know this, we just have to refer to this battery's terminal. As you already learned before, the current will flow from the positive terminal to negative terminal. So it will flow anti-clockwise like this, from here 2 here, this is for current. But for electron, it will flow in the opposite direction with the current, which is from negative terminal to positive terminal, which is from the shorter to the longer side. So it will flow in clockwise direction like this. So this will be the direction of your electron flow. So after we label the direction of electron flow, we will know which electrode gained the electron. So this part gained electron, that means it undergo reduction at cathode according to our acronym. Gain electron, reduction, cathode. So now we know this species copper undergo reduction. So next, how can we determine positive or negative terminal of the cell? The same thing, we refer to batteries or anode value. If we got batteries, then we refer to the terminal of the batteries. So the positive terminal of the battery will be the positive terminal of the cell. Very easy, right? So if we don't have battery, then we have to refer to anode value. So the side with more positive anode value will be your positive terminal. So you see positive, 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 positive. So very easy, right? So the next question, how can we determine the direction of your electron flows? So the same step, you refer to your battery's terminal or anode value if you can't find the battery. I already told you, right? Current will flow from positive to negative terminal, and electron will flow from negative to positive terminal. So this will be your direction of your electrons. So for chemical cell, we don't have battery, so we look at anode value. Then the next step, we will refer to our acronym. So the anode value that is more positive will undergo reduction. So that species will gain electron. That means the electron should go inside this electron. Then from there, we can know the direction of electrons. So this is how chemical cell and electrolytic cell looks like. So we can see this conclusion helped me to simplify a lot of things. I just have to follow these two steps to solve the questions. So if you want to know how I come up with this kind of conclusion, then you have to go back to this part one video. I already explained step by step in this video.
So if you need more guidance, you could join my tutorial class. It's either one-to-one, or if you prefer to learn with your friend, you can come with your friend with maximum 5 students in a class so that I could take good care of each of you. So if you're interested to join this tutorial class, feel free to contact me through this email. Alright, so make sure you like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm tss.thesan. Have a nice day.